that I've been asked if, do you want to do hands, knees, hands or toes? Now, I probably haven't done hands, knees or toes for 38 years or something. When did you stop doing that? When you're like six. So, maybe some little people at the front can help me with the words. Hands, shoulders, that's right, isn't it? Okay, so, ready? Hands, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Right, we need a small person. Can someone bring a small person? Here we go. Yeah, you. Yeah, bring her over. She knows the words. Oh, not allowed. Not allowed. Sorry. Not allowed. Not allowed. Not allowed. I need to learn the words. What? Pardon? Oh, we've got another small person coming up who knows the words to hands, knees and toes. Whoop, whoop, whoop. All right, you're going to sing head, shoulders, knees and toes. Do you know all the words?
Yeah.
All right, you need to get in front of this mic. What's your name?
My name's Sol.
Sol, give it up for Sol! Whee!
That's a lot of people.
That's a lot of people, Sol. They're all the way over there as well. And they're all the way over there, and they're all going to be doing head, shoulders, knees and toes because of your instruction.
Adults, you got to do this as well. Head, shoulders, knees, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, and eyes, and ears, and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes.
Stay there, Sol, because yet again I can see the people at the front making a lot of effort, and the people at the back think we can't see them. We can see you people at the back and you're getting just as cold. So, all together, all for Greta Thunberg, we're all going to do head, shoulders, knees and toes. Off you go, Sol.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, and eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes.
Are you all feeling a bit warmer? Yeah? Are you going to do a little 1 foot to the other foot, 1 foot to the other foot dance? That's it. Shake your bums a bit. Make friends with the people next to you. Have a little, you know, a little wink wink. Oh, hello. What are you going to sing? Are you going to do a dance? What's your name? Hello, Jessica.
Say hello, everyone.
This is Jessica, everybody.
Ten.
How excited, on a scale of 1 to 10, are you excited to see Greta Thunberg?
10.
And would you like to let everyone know what you've been doing with the climate marches? Have you been doing anything?
I made a sign about, like, choose the future.
Hello? Ah, this one's still working. Do you know something that helped keep people warm, Jessica? Do you know heads and shoulders? Do you want to do a bit of heads and shoulders then? All right. Jessica wasn't sure what dance to do, so we're going to do another round of head, shoulders, knees and toes. Why not, hey? But let me just get this mic down to Jessica's level. Oh. Hello. Yours is all good, Jessica?
Yeah.
Okay. So, after three, everybody, people at the back, people at the sides, people queuing for the toilet, the people who have just wandered by, who just want to get to the bus stop, who are wondering what's going on. Here's Head, Shoulders, Knees and Toes from Jessica.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, and eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
Do you want to get everyone to do a Mexican wave? Yeah, you get them all, rally them up from this side. Start with this side.
From that side, we'll do a Mexican wave round to there.
So you guys over that side by the church, we're going to start at your side this time, okay? So we're going to do another Mexican wave, starting with you guys, when Jessica calls you in.
3, 2, 1, go!
Amazing, Jessica. Amazing. So, has anyone got a time check on how long Greta's going to be here? Are we allowed to say? Do we know? 9 minutes. But this is Bristol, so typically she'll probably be late. But who knows? Maybe she won't. Maybe she's not going to come Bristol time. Are you coming up?
Could you ask people in the primary area to move to the right? Let more people to come in. Move to stage right.
Okay, so we're just being, because we've got lots and lots of people who can't actually get in, we're asking all of the people down this side if you can move to the right a bit. So if you can move to the right, and even if you're at the back, if you can move to the right-hand side a bit, so all of these people who are now starting to queue up Park Street, they can't get in. So we need to make more space because there's more people coming. So if you can all move, we can see if you're moving or not because of the umbrellas. That's it. If you can move towards the cathedral, so the people who are coming down Park Street, they can all get in. There's lots and lots of people here and they can't get in. It looks amazing. I've been to so many of these things at College Green and yeah, this one is incredible. Look how many of you there are. This is absolutely amazing. And I know it's raining, but at least the umbrellas make it look pretty, don't they? So that's all good. That's it. Keep on moving, guys. Keep on moving. You guys at the front. That's it. You're coming in. You guys from Park Street, you can start coming in now. That's it. All start coming in. So, anyone know any other dances? Was there the chicken dance? We could do the chicken dance. That's not going to make many friends, is it? Because you're going to have to nick people, but we could all do a chicken dance. A little bit of a chicken dance. Hold on, there's some requests at the front. Let's see. Oh, yes, we've got a request for the front. Another one I'm not exactly sure I'm going to know the words of. So if we have a little people, soul maybe, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Anyone know the words? Happy and you know it, clap your hands. Oh, I know. It's all right. I got it. So who wants to join in both the actions and obviously the singing? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Who's going to join us? Are you feeling happy today, Bristol? Woo! Let the people in the offices hear us behind. Are you feeling happy today, Bristol? Okay, so after three, we're going to do a, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Ready? 1, 2, 3. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Not sure if there's a second verse, so let's do it again. Oh, if you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, Bristol, stamp. you're happy and you know it, nod your head. If you're happy and you know it, nod your head. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, nod your head.
Welcome to ITV News Live as Bristol gets ready to welcome the world famous teenage environmental campaigner, Greta Thunberg. We are right here, and as you can see, thousands upon thousands of people are cramming in. Many have travelled from the length and breadth of the country. They represent all generations, from babies, toddlers, primary schools, through to teenagers of Greta's own generation, through to parents and much older people. It represents a real cross-section of society. We will be live online for about the next hour. We have reporters dotted around the site. You'll be hearing from all of us in turn. You'll also be hearing the speeches in full, including, of course, Greta's. Let me just give you a brief outline of timings. At about 11:15, we have a 15-year-old environmental campaigner called Maya Rose Craig. She is from Bristol. She has won an honorary doctorate from Bristol University for her work in encouraging children from ethnic minorities to join conservation groups. We then hope to hear from Greta herself at about 11:45, and we will, of course, be broadcasting those speeches in full. Now, how did this event come about? Well, London, and just 8 days ago, she contacted the Bristol branch of the Youth Strike for Climate movement, asking if she could that bunch of 17 and 18-year-olds in the movement, because they are only sixth formers like Greta, have had just 8 days to try and organise this massive event. The trajectory of Greta Thunberg's fame is really quite incredible. In August 2018, she was an unknown 15-year-old in Sweden, and she stopped going to school. She went on a school strike, sitting outside the Swedish Parliament in Stockholm day after day, saying that her future was in jeopardy because, as she saw it, not enough was being done. What was the point in her going to school? That argument, that action, caught on. It sparked a massive global campaign in which teenagers all over the world wanted to copy Greta's actions. And in a year and a half, she has become one of the most famous people in the world, and very probably the most famous member of her generation. Let's talk now to a few of the people who are here and see why they've made the decision to stand in Bristol's freezing rain here and hear what Greta has to say. Hello, sir. Now, hello. You're here with your little boys. Where have you come from?
Just from Bath, not far.
Just from Bath. Good. You haven't had to come very long, then.
No.
Now, you've taken them out of school today.
Yep.
Boys, are you happy to be missing school?
Yeah.
Really? Are you sure?
Yeah.
Why have you allowed them to miss school? Why is this so important to you?
Oh, they love school, and they were genuinely a bit like, oh, do we have to miss school? And we have to sort of talk about it, and they're doing a big environmental project at school. They're aware of Greta Thunberg and what she represents, and what she sort of, you know, she has genuinely sparked that flame in them that, you know, what's the point if we haven't got a planet to fight for? What's the point educating ourselves? So we're making sure that we're at least, you know, they know that their voice has to be heard, and, you know, it's their future.
Okay, fabulous. How are you? Hello, everyone. We're live on ITV News Online. Guys, why have you come here today?
A local secondary school, and so we've got a lot of students and staff participating today to show our support.
And so you allowed the students to miss Friday. That was okay. They're not going to land in detention, are they?
No, not at all, no. The whole school's been given the day off so that we can come and get behind the cause and show our support.
Why do you think Greta Thunberg has become such a global phenomenon?
I think it's brilliant to see somebody that can vocalise how a lot of young people are feeling, and really see the amount of students that have turned up here today is just so inspiring, really inspiring.
By the way, if you're seeing some dropout in the signal, it's because we're relying on 4G for this broadcast, and as you can imagine, the 4G mobile networks are very much in demand at the moment. So now let's cross to some more live picture of today's as Greta gets ready to arrive on the main stage.
I'm Sagisa reporting on ITV News Live. If you've just joined us, then you're just in time because Greta Thunberg has not spoken yet. But thousands have turned up on College Green in the centre of Bristol to see her speak. It's an incredibly big day for the city, with thousands of children and young people leaving school to be here to see a woman who's become their role model at just 17 years old. She's become one of the most prominent climate change activists, only really picking up momentum in the last 18 months after she was seen sat outside the Swedish Parliament. In the last hour, this crowd has quadrupled in size. I mean, it's an incredibly wet day, but spirits here are pretty high. We've had a few acts on stage trying to get kids warmed up with head, shoulders, knees and toes and dancing. They're expecting speaks in the next hour or so, and they'll be rallying on a march through the centre of Bristol, which has been completely closed off. All of the roads have been closed until about 5 o'clock this afternoon. They'll be leaving College Green here and moving down this way through the centre, I imagine, picking up a lot of momentum along the way from onlookers and people passing by. Many people here have said they've never actually seen anything like this in this city before. Again, everyone is incredibly excited to see her speak. This is just a fraction of the support Greta has built over the last 18 months across the world, and all organised by two 17-year-olds based here in Bristol, who actually only got a text from Greta about 8 days ago. They say they've been working in partnership with Avon and Somerset Police to try and make this as safe an event as possible. They've got a safe zone at the front. They've got about 90 of their own stewards ready. We've just got someone speaking on stage now, thanking everyone for turning up. Everyone waiting in anticipation for Greta to be on stage. She arrived at Bristol Temple Meads on train about an hour ago, we believe. She's not on just yet. We've got a bit of music to keep people going. But she is expected to be here in a few minutes. And we've got so many people waiting to see her. Hello, sir. Are you waiting to see Greta?
Yeah, sure.
Why are you here to see her?
Why not? She's doing a great job.
Why do you think...
Now the crowd here is growing and growing all the time. Still no sign of Greta, but she is in Bristol. We're expecting her at any moment. Let's talk a little more to some of the thousands and thousands of people who are standing out here in Bristol's finest weather. Hello guys, why are you here today? Are you Greta fans?
Yeah.
And are you kind of worried about environmental issues?
Yeah, definitely.
What do you hope she'll say? What do you hope she'll talk about?
I don't know.
Let's keep looking. Let's find. Hello, guys.
Hello.
Now, are you a family?
No.
So my daughter and another family right here.
Now it looks like you're out of school today.
Yes, I am.
Is that allowed? Are you going to be in detention?
No, definitely not. I'm determined to not be in detention.
What has your school said about people coming on the marches today?
So they're not too bothered about it. Even teachers want to go on the march because they think it's really important. They said, you know, it's not a hobby, it's a passion, and it's not just something that's pointless. It actually matters.
And how old are you?
I'm 12.
You're 12. Do you and your friends talk a lot about the environment? Is it something that worries 12-year-olds?
My friends do.
Your very camera-shy friend.
Yeah.
Do you sort of worry about this?
I do, because we don't know if we're going to have a future. I mean, I asked my mum if she could come to the... She said, well, I have to work. But what's the point of working if in 10 years' time you're not going to have a job?
Now, Greta is only 5 years older than you.
Yes.
She's still very young. She's a sixth former, basically, isn't she? Does that really excite you guys, that she is kind of your generation?
Yeah, it does. It does. And people... I hope that people in the future are going to be saying, well, we were such a good generation, you know, encouraging others to do something about this because no one's listening.
That's new, isn't it, sir? This generation saying that they are worried about the environment. When we were 12, we probably weren't saying that sort of thing.
I don't recall it being a worry when I was growing up. I think one of the things we were worried about was where we're going to get the sources of energy from. And over time, we've got the technology to figure out we can have renewable energy. However, in terms of the environment and the impact that we've had on it, who knows what's going to happen? I mean, right now in the country, we've got floods that are unprecedented, like we've never seen before, and we don't know what direction this is going to take. So I think these youngsters, I think they've got the finger on the pulse. I think we need to be more aware and make some changes.
Talking about this event in particular, obviously we've got this 17-year-old who's inspired a phenomenal global movement. Do you think local schools, well, schools all over the place, do you think they're right to allow or even encourage their pupils to be here?
As a school teacher? It's a yes and no. I think if it's a genuine concern and it's not an excuse to, you know, forego, you know, the academics, you know, learning and so forth, I think this is a valuable experience.
Okay, thanks very much, guys, for talking to us. You have got the umbrella for the occasion. I'm quite envious. Right, let's go now to some more live picture of what is becoming a huge event here in central Bristol.
Alex and Issa reporting on ITV News Live. We are just about to see if Greta is arriving on stage now. We've actually had to move a little bit further out from the crowd because so many people are now piling in to College Green at the bottom of Park Street here. It's all closed off and will be for most of the day, actually. But people are just so excited. A lot of people have said that they're frustrated at the closure, but also cannot believe that Greta Thunberg has... She's arrived. We believe that she's pretty close to College Green and expected to be on stage soon, even though the weather is incredibly wet. Everyone here is in high spirits. About a few acts on stage. Thousands of people have arrived and about 25,000 are expected. We've got a few ladies here. Are you waiting to see Greta?
Yeah, to see Greta.
And why do you think she's so important?
I think she's just sparked like a really big change. Like she's just got everything kind of.
Everyone thinking.
Yeah.
Have you left school or university today?
College. Yeah.
How did it feel leaving sixth form to be here?
It was just important. Do you know what I mean? Important to join the course sort of thing.
What do you think about this crowd that's turned up?
It's huge.
I know. I didn't expect it.
Have you ever seen this number of people in the centre of Bristol?
We've been to like protests before, but it's never been this big.
Yeah, it's great.
I mean, at just 17 years old, she's gained so much momentum, hasn't she? Yeah. So much support.
Yeah. Yeah.
Only in the last year, really, that we've been hearing of Greta.
Yeah.
What do you think about, you know, how she's been able to engage younger people in, you know, climate change?
Like, having a younger person doing it is really important. It's not like it's more relatable because it's like somebody their age that like
we can get involved in and it'll help.
Brilliant. Yeah. Are you going to be walking in the protest through the city centre today?
Yeah.
And how does it feel to be part of it?
It's exciting, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's like there's a movement. Like, I mean, we'll look back on this.
Yeah,
you know,
it's making history.
Important.
Yeah.
Thank you, ladies. Yeah, have a good day.
You.
Well, as you see, people are just incredibly excited to hear Greta Thunberg speak. You know, as they were saying, she's engaged so many young people into fighting against climate change. And she's only really been doing that in the spotlights for the last 18 months. And this is a fraction of the support that Greta Thunberg has globally. We're yet to see when she's going to come on stage, but it is expected to be soon. And we'll obviously be keeping you updated. If you want to stay across this feed, we'll have all of the latest updates for you throughout the day.
Me and Sam in the car, talking about America. Heading to the wishing well, we've reached our last resort. I turned to him, said, man, help me out. I fear I'm on an island in an ocean full of change. Can't bring myself to dive into an ocean full of change. Am I losing touch? Am I losing touch now? He said, why, what a terrible time to be alive if you're prone to overthinking it. Why, what a terrible time to be alive if you're prone to second guessing it. Hey, pretty smiling people, we're all right together.
Coming. It's so great to see so many of you here, and I know so many of you have traveled really far for this event, and it brings so much joy to my heart and all of everyone here's hearts to know that you all come and support Greta and the rest of us. In the interest of regional diversity, it's great to see an event of this size outside of London. My name is Millie, and I'm one of the organizers of this event. So a lot of you know that we only got the call about Greta coming about 8 days ago, and so the fact that we managed to do all of this in a day has been one of the most stressful times of my life and everyone else in the group's lives. So I just want to say, can we have a round of applause for everyone that organized this? So before we begin properly, I have two statements to read from people that were going to have their events on this day. So the first one is, supporting us today are hundreds of members from the health community, doctors, nurses, and medical students. They've been telling us that this is a health crisis. Like we have said time and time again, the climate crisis is a health crisis. We have to listen to the experts on this. Here in Bristol, it wouldn't be right to talk about health without saying that all of Bristol's NHS hospital trusts have declared a climate emergency. Secondly, after the march, we will also hear from Save the M32 Maples. It's a local community campaign in St. Paul's, and they're desperately trying to prevent the destruction of mature urban trees to protect local health and well-being in the most polluted part of the city. The campaign is at a critical stage, and they would like to tell their story. So after the event, if you come back here, there'll be a couple more speeches from these groups. They're going to talk about why we must protect the trees and the challenges from the council and underhand developers. So that's all from me. I know you're all excited about what we have coming up, so I won't keep you for any longer. Thank you for listening. I hope you have a good day and stay safe. So Frances from UKSCN is going to speak next, and she's going to talk about the demands for the country.
Good morning, Bristol! It's amazing that you've all come out here in the wet weather, like, whole sea of you, like, this is great. So 2020 is a key year for action. In November this year, there's COP26, which is the UN Climate Action Summit, and national governments have a really big responsibility because every 5 years they have to renew their pledges that were made in the Paris Agreement to reduce emissions. So us being here today and this year is the year that we need to pressure them to make those targets more ambitious. So what do we want as the youth strikers? We have four demands for our government. The first one is to implement a Green New Deal to achieve climate justice.
Reporting on ITV News Live. If you just joined us, then you've still got a bit of time before Greta gets on stage here. The crowd is incredibly big. We keep having to move further out because we are aiming to be at the front of the protest as they leave College Green to then head on through the city centre. In preparation for this, though, all of the roads in the middle of the city have been closed from about 9 o'clock this morning. They're expected to be closed until about 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Of course, that has caused huge disruption for the city, all organised by two 17-year-olds who say they've been working with Avon and Somerset Police to try and minimise the amount of disruption and also make this as safe an event as they possibly can. They've got festival railings out at the front where the bulk of the crowd is, and a few of the streets along the route that they're planning on going down have also been closed off. So if you're planning on coming down here, give yourself plenty of time. They're hoping to pick up momentum for more people to see Greta walking through the city centre for the first time. As they go through the streets, they're going to leave College Green after Greta has spoken, head down towards the fountains, and then work their way up towards Cabot. And then they'll end up going through Castle Park and coming back round again. It's been a similar route that's been mimicked by other people like Extinction Rebellion, who've protested in the past for action against climate change. They'll be following a similar route. So if you caught up in that disruption, then expect to experience that again. Now, there are plenty of stewards on hand to help and also police officers. Everyone here, though, seems pretty calm and just excited to hear Greta speak. They appreciate it's going to cause disruption in the city today, but they argue that that disruption is needed to protect the environment and protect our planet from further damage, which they say needs to be acted on now. Of course, thousands of people here are actually children and young adults who've left school today, who've left sixth form. Many of them are supervised, but of course that's the anticipation. You know, there are a lot of children here and it's a very big crowd. But again, I spoke to Avon and Somerset police officers earlier today. They say they're extremely aware of the demographic of this crowd and they're aware that they are going to support her. But I do believe that Greta Meyer, I'm being told that it's not Greta just yet, but the crowd is getting pretty quiet. So it seems like they're listening out for a speaker. Ah, Maya Rose is on stage. She is known on Twitter as Bird Girl. So she's actually one of the youngest in the world to get an honorary doctorate from the University of Bristol. She's been incredibly influential against climate change and actually trying to highlight the importance of protecting our environment for wildlife. And she's also been incredibly influential in engaging members of the BME community in bird watching herself. She's speaking at the moment, and then we're expecting Greta Thunberg to come on after her. She herself is an incredibly young activist. She's an incredibly young bird watcher. She's been doing bird watching since she was about 6 or 7. Again, Greta Thunberg is gaining more momentum from people who are young women. And that's something, actually, I spoke to one lady earlier who's left sixth form today. She said that the only reason she really got engaged in what Greta was saying was because she was a 17-year-old young woman. Well, anyway, everyone is excited to hear what she has to say. She'll be on stage in a few minutes.
To try and combat this issue, I started an organisation called Black to Nature, which organises camps for VME teenagers to help them connect with nature and discuss environmental issues. Over the last 5 years, I've worked with hundreds of kids to try and help them really experience nature. And these kids tell me how schools stop them from striking and insist on parental consent, which the parents themselves won't give because they don't understand properly about the issue of climate change. And these schools are threatening these children with isolation or exclusion, which cannot be allowed. And we're not going to stop caring about our natural world just because they don't want to listen to us. So now is the time to finally listen to young people. We need to see... But this is about the bigger picture too. The Global North has created this massive issue and we have to take responsibility for fixing it rather than trying to pass the cost and the pain down to the Global South and those who have contributed the least to climate breakdown. My mum's family is Bangladesh. Oh, okay, wait, what are they saying? Oh. Oh, okay, sorry. Yes. Wait, 1 second. What's going on, sorry?
If we have a medic, can we please send them to the middle where the PA stack is, the big black speakers? Any first aid trained medics, please? You see that she's down in the middle. Waving hands in the middle there, thank you.
Yeah, right. Go around the end, it will be time through.
Any first aid trained medics, please? Waving hands in the middle there. Thank you.
Sorry, I didn't realise.
Telling people to stop buying foreign fast fashion is going to create dire consequences for the people least responsible for climate change and consumerism. Instead, we need to help them create a new livelihood. Another example is the batteries in electric cars. They need cobalt, but 15% of this is mined by African children. The solutions for stopping climate change cannot rely on the exploitation of human beings. We have to think about the impact on the most vulnerable people as we work our way towards a sustainable Earth. This means the system has to change. Everything that you're doing to prevent climate change is amazing and is so needed. But we also need our leaders to step up and act now, because families and children like us are suffering now. Last year, there was an unseasonal flood in my granddad's village in Bangladesh, and it swept away all of their rice crop, meaning they didn't have any food for that year or the next. And if we hadn't been able to send money, they would have starved to death. A Somali boy who came to one of my camps told me the same thing is happening in Somalia. We need to connect these disasters to the climate emergency so that Vietnamese people understand, link, and relate the issue and join the fight. And things are just getting worse. Climate breakdown is going to create a massive refugee crisis due to flooding, drought, and famine. At 1.5 degrees Celsius, the conservative estimate is 69 million refugees. That's more than the population of the UK. And if there's 2 degrees of warming, it's going to be 80 million refugees. In Dhaka, the capital city of Bangladesh, there's already 4 million refugees, which is nearly 8 times the population of Bristol. And we're also facing an ecological emergency. We've wiped out nearly 60% of animal population in the last 50 years. In the UK, our biodiversity loss is staggering. We are ranked 189th out of 218 countries on how depleted our biodiversity is. But it's not all doom and gloom, sorry. There is so much happening, and all of you being here today shows that. I'm really proud to be an ambassador for Survival International, which is an organization that fights for the rights of Indigenous peoples around the world. And I was contacted this week by Sandra Mai, an Indigenous campaigner for the Ecuadorian Amazon, where I've stayed with Indigenous peoples, who is telling me about the Amazon rivers being poisoned by mining, killing people and fish. She said, "Only together can we face these global challenges. Why should we allow mining when reparation is impossible? Please help us to amplify our voices. Please help us to save our rivers, our jungle, our home." And and we're here today to work together and to amplify all of our voices. Greta Thunberg is leading the charge to a bright future, and we're all right behind her. I believe that to do the best job we can, we must consider climate change through a lens of poverty, politics, strife, and racism. This is why an inclusive and diverse youth movement is essential. We must look at who's affected and how they're affected. Now, more than ever, it's important to remember that inequality of engagement creates inequality of an opportunity, and an unequal world can never be a sustainable one. Thank you. So one of the biggest questions we've been asked in this last week is why Bristol? While there are a variety of answers to this, one of the most important is looking back at what we have achieved as a city in the past year. It's been a massive year for climate action, and the environmental movement in Bristol is one of the largest in the UK. Firstly, in February of 2019, Bristol students staged a mass walkout for the first time to demand climate action. This was building upon the November 2018 declaration of a climate emergency by Bristol City Council, the first in Europe and the second in the world. This movement has played a hugely important part in holding the council to account for their ambitious pledge. In September of 2019, 15,000 adults and children alike gathered on College Green as part of the Global Strike for Climate, alongside millions of strikers in the largest climate mobilization in history. We were the second largest strike in the entire country. In November, we held our own climate hustings in the run-up to the general election. We featured local MP candidates who were asked questions on their party's climate policies, which was the perfect opportunity to engage young people in local issues and get their voices heard. And then finally, this month, we've managed to contribute to the campaign to successfully stop the proposed expansion of Bristol Airport. But despite having a carbon neutrality pledge 20 years earlier than the rest of the country, we need to do more than pledge. We need to have action as well as words. And Heilewin's going to talk to you more about that. Woo! So, yeah, obviously it's amazing that we've made incredible declarations for carbon neutrality and a climate crisis and an ecological crisis, but there's no plan in place. With 10 years to reach carbon neutrality, that means we have to get rid of all petrol cars, all diesel cars, all gas boilers from Bristol. And considering we're still selling all of those things and they have a lifetime longer than 10 years, a plan needs to be put in now. So, with the mayoral elections coming up, what we need is for all the candidates to put in place a two-term plan of how they're going to reach this goal. Because without putting that in now, we're never going to reach it in time. So, when I started this, I was only 16 and I didn't really do anything and I felt quite young. But in 2 days, I'm going to be 18, and so I will be voting in this election and I won't be voting for anyone that doesn't have a viable plan. And I hope none of you will be voting for anyone that doesn't have a plan either. Thank you.
Wow. Hello, Bristol. Can you make some noise? Isaac, can you make some noise so Greta can hear you? My name is Katie, or Katie Climate, and I am your penultimate speaker. Hold on, we've got some waving in the crowd. Is everything okay over there? We need a medic. Are we getting a medic over there?
medic.
Hello again. I am deep in the middle of the crowd, a crowd that is getting increasingly soaked. But of course, no one is going anywhere because we hope to hear from Greta any minute now. Apparently, she is sheltering in Bristol Cathedral. Lucky her. The rest of us are out here getting soaking wet. Guys, look at these wonderful signs. We're destroying the wrong Amazon. What's the one at the back say? Listen to Greta. Things will get better. We've got, this is our last warning. Stop global warming. So another lot of people not in school today. Is it mums here?
Yeah.
Hello, guys. Why did you feel the need to come and stand in the rain today?
To show the children. Sorry, go for it.
to help our children's future. Our governments are being completely inactive, and I think that by having children here protesting, it should shame them into action.
What do you think of Greta herself?
Well, I think she's a bit of an icon, really. I think she's doing something that is quite wildly out of a lot of 17-year-olds' kind of dreams, really. I really support what she's doing and how she's doing it.
Okay, now, hello, guys. Did you enjoy making your signs?
Yeah.
You've got an ice cream cone on yours. Talk me through that one.
So it's like the world is melting, so it's all falling apart.
Like an ice cream in summer. Okay, and what's on your sign?
Stop flying, our planet is dying.
Okay, did you make these at school or at home?
At home.
Did you? Oh, and you've all done, that's some lovely signs. Yours looks very strong there. And do you think things, this is a question for grown-ups again, do you think gatherings like this are going to change anything in reality?
I have no idea. We can only hope. I mean, I don't know what else we can do apart from gathering large crowds with our children and, I don't know, shout really loud.
Also the disruption that it causes and the fact that it will inconvenience local government should hopefully have an impact on central government and the fact that they should start taking notice, because this is going to cost the taxpayer millions, but so is climate change. So actually take some action that's positive, that's peaceful, disrupt the peace, and hopefully central government will take notice.
And it certainly has disrupted central Bristol today. Many of the city centre roads closed, many schools closed as well. Let's go now to some more live picture at the front of the stage.
But there is still so much to do, and we need to be conscious of that. Indigenous people's land is still being plundered for corporate profit. The UK government is still funding oil and gas projects in the global south. I could go on. What we need is reparations to those who are most affected by the climate crisis and initiatives that amplify marginalised voices. What we need mostly is a rewilding of our imagination so that solidarity, justice, love and unity are at the forefront of our minds. There is so much to do, but there is so much power in not just getting angry, but getting active. And no one does this better than Bristol Youth Strike for Climate, which I am so proud to be a part of. I met these young people 1 year ago, and I have sat in awe over the past 12 months at their dedication, their commitment, and their devotion to climate justice. They meet every week, and they have organized 10 protests and marches. Together, we have put on this protest and march in just 1 week, and we have been working all around the clock. We're so tired. So I was going to invite them on stage and introduce you to them, but this stage is a bit too small. But I would like you now to take a moment and show your appreciation for Bristol Youth Strike for Climate. And now, our next speaker has come all the way from Sweden, and she is just 17 years old. There should be no such thing as a youth environmental activist. There should be no such thing as young people enacting the responsibilities of our elected politicians. We owe them so much, and right now what we owe Greta is a big, warm, Bristolian welcome. Greta, Greta, Greta.
Hello, everyone. Before we do, can I have your attention? We want to make this strike as accessible and safe for everyone as possible. And I think we would all be more comfortable if we could all just take a step back, just give ourselves a bit of a shuffle, but get a bit more comfortable. So it, just to make it more comfortable for everyone here before Greta comes on. Thank you for your attention. Just everyone, half a step back. Half a step back for everyone. Thank you very much.
Do we need another medic in the middle? We need a medic in the middle. By the speakers. Please, can you pass this message forwards? We need an ambulance.
Okay. We need a stretcher. It organized, it's on its way. They're on the radio and we can assure you it's okay. Right, now I need everyone.
I am so happy to introduce Greta Thunberg! Thank you so much, every single one of you, for being here. And I'm so happy to be here in Bristol with all of you. There will be a time when we will look back and ask ourselves what we did right now. How do we want to be remembered? This is an emergency. People are already suffering and dying from the consequences of the climate and environmental emergency. But it will get worse. And still, this emergency is being completely ignored by the politicians,
the media and those in power. Basically, nothing is being done to halt this crisis, despite all the beautiful words and promises from our elected officials. So what did we do during this crucial time? What we will do right now? Well, I will not stand aside and watch. I will not be silent while the world is on fire. Will you? World leaders are behaving like children. So it falls on us to be the adults in the room. It should not be this way. We should not be the ones who will have to lead on this and tell the uncomfortable truth. Once again, they sweep their mess under the rug for us young people, for their children to clean up for them. But we must continue, and we have to be patient and remember that the changes required will not happen overnight, since the politics and the solutions needed are still far from sight. But if enough people are pushing for change, then change will come. And we are those people. And every single person counts. Just look at Bristol as an example. The other week, the plans to expand the Bristol airport were cancelled, a lot thanks to climate activists. And of course, this is far from enough, but it shows that it does actually make a difference. Activism works, so I'm telling you to act. If you look throughout history, all the great changes have come from the people. We are being betrayed by those in power, and they are failing us, but we will not back down. And if you feel threatened by that, then I have some very bad news for you. We will not be silenced, because we are the change, and change is coming whether you like it or not. Thank you, and let's march.
Well, Greta has just come off stage now, and now the protest is going to move. So it's leaving here on College Green at the bottom of Park Street, and everyone that was just at College Green is expected to move through the city centre. The city centre has been closed off. All the roads have been closed for about 9 o'clock this morning. We're now moving with the protest Greta is expected to move along as well. She spoke for about 5 or 10 minutes on stage. And now thousands of people that watched that speech are heading through the city centre. They'll be going towards Cabot, and they'll also go through Castle Park and doing a bit of a loop, ending back at the harbourside here.
There's toilets on Polish Green over near the cathedral, and they'll stay here throughout the march. And also, as you're leaving, please pick up any rubbish, even if it's not yours. We know that some of you have taken part in legal actions, such as road blocking in the past. We want the strikes to be as inclusive as possible, and actions like this form a significant barrier to entry for many strikers, especially children.
And now, in another part of the crowd, tens of thousands of people are moving off College Green, the main open space right in the middle of Bristol, and heading down to the harbour side as they join Greta on the climate march. This is the part that the local police, Avon and Somerset, had worried about. The sheer number of people who are now funneling through the streets of central Bristol. They had warned that they didn't feel they were able to police this event adequately because of the huge unexpected numbers and because of the very fluid nature of it. At the start of the day, we wondered how many people would actually turn up because the weather was so foul. The weather has remained foul for the past 2 hours, and yet College Green, as you'll have seen, has remained absolutely packed, rammed, as people listened to Greta's relatively short speech, but no less powerful because it was short. So everyone now moving off gradually down to the march to make their feelings known. Let's take a look at that now.
So I thought we could do some chants.
So I was going to do a speech, but I thought there's no way on God's earth I can top what Greta and the other speakers have done. So I thought we could do some chants, that's why I'm with you lot. You're going to ask me what you want, and you're going to tell me what you want. And that's why we're chatting. What do you want?
That's good, but they're all so much better, so what about... Repeat after me.
Thank you. I hope you can hear me above the speakers on the stage. The stage which Greta Thunberg has just left. You heard the speech just a minute ago. Only lasted about 5 or 10 minutes, but it was very clear in its message. She said, the people of the country, of the world, have been betrayed by those in power, but she says, we will not be silenced. We will be listened to. Change is coming. The rain is still coming here. There is not a blade of grass left on the floor. We've been stood here for about an hour and a half. We are in the media pen, just a few feet from the stage, which has been vacated by Greta now. She's going to join the front of the march. We're just going to talk to a few young people now who've heard Greta's speech. What did you think of what you heard?
I think it was really inspirational, and just thinking that we would be like, we could be like her if we really tried and carry on doing these big things.
How about you?
She's so young and she's such an inspiration. And what she says is,
we all love each other.
So you're glad you came in this rain and the mud and you've missed school for this?
Yeah, definitely. It was just an amazing experience seeing her and listening to her speech.
It wasn't very long, but her message was quite strong.
Yeah, her message
extremely.
Was really strong.
Yeah.
So it was really strong and clear as well.
And you're joining the march as well now?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck. Thank you for joining us on ITV News Live from College Green in the heart of Bristol. If you've just joined us, we are on College Green in the centre of Bristol. Greta Thunberg has just given us a short speech from the stage. There are tens of thousands of people here braving this weather, but they are all moving out into the city centre, which has been closed, to march across a mile and a half route back here to the College Green. I think we can show you pictures from the start of that march now. Let's see those pictures now.
Well, as you can see, we're right at the front of where the march will start. Stewards are linking arms to get the crowd ready. Where we're stood right now is where that almost iconic samba band associated with the anti-climate protests will be based. And then once they start, we'll all be moving along through the city centre. But I mean, just look at that. Bristol city centre has completely stopped for Greta's visit. She spoke for about 5 minutes on stage, and as soon as she came off, the crowd moved this way. We're right at the bottom of Park Street, which has been closed off since about 9 o'clock this morning. It will remain closed for much of the day. Of course, this is causing huge disruption for the city, but activists here say that disruption is needed to continue their movement to act on climate change to protect our environment. I'm imagining that beyond this, there are thousands of people, which I'm sure you've probably been able to see from some of our colleagues and other cameras that we've got dotted around here. We're giving you a live feed of everything that's happening today if you've just joined us. Stay with us for any updates of how this movement goes through the city centre. It's expected to follow along Park Street at the bottom here, past the fountains in the city centre, and then going towards Castle Park, and then it'll make a loop all the way back round again. Obviously, this takes a lot of security to keep it safe. The two 17-year-olds that organised this event in Bristol say they've been working with Avon and Somerset Police to try and keep it as safe as possible. Around me, actually, behind the camera, we've got police officers protecting the line as it moves. An incredible sight for Bristol, though. It's the first time Greta has visited the city, and this turnout is huge. Tens of thousands of people have turned up to see her speak. Many of them children. You can probably see there on the front row, we've got a few kids, all seem to be supervised, all with smiling faces, having just seen someone that has been a role model for them now, 17-year-old Greta Thunberg. So it seems like the crowd is getting quite compact behind this front line. Before, you were able to sort of see through it, but now it seems the crowds are ready to head on.
Thank you.
Well, you join us back live on College Green in the centre of Bristol for this Youth Climate March. You can see that a lot of the crowd have now left, leaving behind an absolute sea of mud. There is not a blade of grass left on this patch in the centre of Bristol. People are making their way to the city centre just across beyond the end of that shot. But there has been a message announced to telling people to stay exactly where they are for now. That's because the crowd is so large, it cannot accommodate the amount of people who are making their way to the city centre, just some couple of hundred yards away. Greta, I believe, is at the front or towards the front of that. There have been a couple of incidents in the crowd where people had to be attended to by medics. An ambulance was called for at one point. I did see an elderly gentleman being led very carefully out of the crowd. He is okay, I'm told. But there have been tens of thousands of people in a patch of land that is really only designed to cover a maximum of about 6,000 people. So the space is very, very cramped. There's music now just playing out on the speakers, as you can probably hear, but most people are moving away from this sea of mud and towards the centre of the centre of the city. I believe we can see a shot now from on high, which shows you the size of the crowd that's trying to gather for the start of this march. I've been told just in the last few seconds that the march route has changed slightly to try to accommodate such a large number of people.
So we're right at the front of where the crowd has moved off College Green now to the bottom of Park Street. We've actually been told to move a little bit further down by the officers because they're going to start the march in a few minutes. They're expecting it to last about an hour, but it completely depends on how the crowd moves and how well and compact they're able to keep moving through the city centre. They're going to end up at Castle Park and then coming back round in a loop. The crowd here is just incredible, and what you won't be able to see is the number of faces in the surrounding windows. So all the businesses here, you've got different shops and businesses up Park Street and a hotel just here. Most windows, you can just see curious faces looking down to see what's actually happening in the centre of Bristol. It's the first time Greta Thunberg has visited the city. A huge moment for everyone here. So she spoke for about 5 or 10 minutes on stage, then moved off. And that's when all of the crowd came over from College Green. They've all braved pretty poor conditions, which seem to be clearing up now, ready for the march.
We're back on College Green. You join us for this ITV News Live special in the centre of Bristol, where we've just heard Greta Thunberg give her address to a crowd of thousands, mainly young people. Let's talk to a few of them now. They're still here waiting to join the march. Are you going off to the march? You're trying to get there. Where the front of the march is, no one quite knows. What exactly is happening at the moment? What are your intentions? What did you think of what you've just heard?
Well, I love Greta.
I didn't really hear much.
I love Greta. She's amazing. I think she's gonna. The world wouldn't be the same without her. keep using plastic. Joking, yeah.
Have you been inspired by what she's said? Have you heard her, seen her before?
Greta is my inspiration, and I'm just so happy she's alive.
I just like to say.
Don't know what I'm doing.
I just like to say.
Quickly, you're alive.
Greta, keep doing what you're doing, because you're making a massive change.
There's no planet B.
Well, you can hear the sentiment there from some of the young people here today. It's a sentiment that's been said many times throughout the morning, and we will be, of course, in the days, weeks, months, years ahead. There is a real power, energy here. You feel a real movement for change, something Greta Thunberg talked about on the stage, saying that the people in power have betrayed the youth of today. They will not be silenced, and change is coming. That got a huge response.
Just being moved to ask to move a little bit further back because so we're actually having to be we're going to keep moving back now because the police officers here say that Greta is on their way. And we're going to be heading, So Greta Thunberg is going to be coming from this direction here. So we're just moving out the way so that she can get to the front of the march. So we might be able to see her if we stay here. Yeah.
I just want to thank you all both for coming, and this concludes the event on Corner Street. The march will be moving down Park Street. If there's any confusion, we're going down Park Street. I hope you all enjoy yourselves, and I hope that you enjoy the march, which seems to be moving. So you can all go enjoy that. Yeah, thank you very much.
You said you
Well, I am still here on College Green, as even now, thousands of people are trying to join the march, but there's really a complete blockage of humanity in that direction, because there are simply far too many people wanting to participate in this Greta Thunberg-led march than the streets will allow. So there's a lot of standing around, but nonetheless, people very motivated to try and join in. It was interesting listening to Greta's speech. One of the statements she said that got the biggest cheer from the crowd was when she mentioned that the application to massively expand Bristol Airport was rejected in the past month. That has been a real political hot potato in these parts for a long time. And then, of course, just yesterday, we heard the application to build a third runway at Heathrow Airport was declared illegal in its current form by the Court of Appeal. And Greta said this was evidence that climate activism like this really works, that if people make a fuss, go on protests, hold these gatherings, disrupt traffic, do what these people are doing here, that it can have a tangible impact. And as I say, that got an enormous cheer from the crowd around me. And it's with that spirit that these people are determined to try and join in what is supposed to be a march in the centre of Bristol. Let's take a look at how it's getting on at the front.
Welcome back to College Green, where the marchers are trying to make their way into the city centre. I'm joined by Kai, who's one of the organisers. Thanks for sparing the time. Just tell us what's happening right now.
So the event on College Green has just finished. All of our speeches have went well, and the march is just about to start. We can see people going down into the city centre. I mean, I haven't been down there, so I can't say what it's like down in there, but we're seeing standing up on stage, there's thousands and thousands of people. So this march is going to be very long, and I think it's going to be amazing.
there were some warnings before the event about public safety and people coming almost at their own risk. Clearly, you've got a huge number of people trying to join this. Are you worried for people's safety right now?
Of course, safety is a massive concern for us, which is why we've been working really closely with the police and with our team of stewards to make sure that we put every precaution in place to keep everyone safe. And we think that with our combined planning, that we should be okay.
But at the moment, things are being delayed at somewhat. It's just the sheer volume of people that want to circuit the centre.
Yeah, there definitely will be a delay just due to the number of people. But slowly we can see people filtering down, and hopefully in time the march will get on its way as we expect it to.
It certainly left its mark, not least on the grass behind us. How would you sum up today's event so far?
I think it's been amazing to see Greta get up on stage and speak, and also to get the spotlight on Bristol to highlight what we've been doing. The fact that we declared a climate emergency, our 20-year and more ambitious carbon neutrality target than the rest of the country. It's amazing to get that on the news, so to inspire people around the country that a more ambitious carbon neutrality target is possible and it is achievable, and so we can hold our politicians to account and make sure that they act on the plans that they promised us.
And what has Greta said to you guys so far about her welcome and the response that she's received beforehand and to her speech?
I mean, Bristol's always been at the forefront of the environmental movement, and seeing the sheer volume of people who have come out on College Green today, it shows how welcome she is in Bristol and how glad we are to see her and have youth strikes in Bristol on a regular basis.
There was a plan to go off somewhere else with her this afternoon to see the wall that's been created in her honour, if you like. That's not going to happen now.
Yes, I think with the sheer volume of people, trying to get her over there would just not be safe for her. And obviously that's our top priority, so no. Although I'm sure she would have loved to have seen the mural of herself.
Hi, thank you very much indeed. Thanks for all your time and your efforts today. Well, there you have it. The march is slowly starting. It will take a long time to circuit the city centre, a mile and a half at least. Certainly an hour or two, we are estimating. The rain continues to fall, but there is a real passion amongst the crowd, determined to have their voices heard and to be seen demonstrating today.
We are right at the front of the march. It got pretty busy a little bit earlier. That's because Greta joined us and everyone just basically wanted to see her. Everyone converged to the front of the march, which is now moving down. If you just follow me, we'll just keep moving because we are right at the front of the protest. So Greta and the band are a little bit further back. They'll be making their way, following us actually, towards Cabot Circus, and then they'll be going over to Castle Park. It's going to take about an hour, they reckon. Everyone just seems pretty excited. So what you've got is a parade of people watching and looking on to see Greta. She's become an icon and role model for so many young people. It's the first time she's visited Bristol City, a city which is on complete standstill for this moment. The roads have been closed since about 9 o'clock. Incredible to think of the amount of support that she's gathered in just 18 months.
That's not going to get any better.
And if you just spin around and have a look, that is what is behind us. Tens of thousands of people showing their support for Greta Thunberg. Just a 17-year-old who has gained so much momentum in the last 18 months. She started, just sat outside a Swedish parliament, fighting for people to understand the impact pollution is having to this planet. Now, arguably the most prominent climate change activist in the world. Apologies if you're hearing any swearing.
Out the way, please.
Incredible, incredible moment for the city.
Thank you.
you can probably see, the crowd is now moving through the centre of this city. That's the iconic sandband that is alongside her. So much excitement to see Greta Thunberg moving through the city centre. Everyone just trying to get a glimpse of her.
John, make it look as well.
Please, can you step back a bit?
And here on College Green, the rain is still falling. Over there, thousands of people still waiting to join the march, still unable to actually start walking. Such is the size of the crowd trying to funnel through Bristol streets. College Green here has seen many a huge public gathering in its time. It's been many, many years since it saw something on this size. It was fully turfed before this morning, about 2 hours ago. There is now not a blade of grass to be seen. Such is the extraordinary magnetism of a 17-year-old from Stockholm. That brings us to the end of this ITV News live online special. Thank you so much for joining us.